Morning, everybody. We will give a quick presentation about the future of buildings in steel. So we'll try to explore what is the future of our business. The outline will include the evolution of steel buildings, a quick glance on the history of buildings, the recent applications of the steel, the building of in steel potentials, the steel challenges, what challenges we are facing, and the shape of the future. What will be the shape of the future of steel buildings, and some points about the keys to future. So historically, the evolution of steel buildings, as everybody knows in our region, in the, can you hear me properly? Voice is clear? Okay. As everybody knows, the steel building usage in our region, either in the Middle East or Southeast Asia or India, it was in the last decades limited to heavy industrial plants, to industrial facilities, and warehouses mainly. But for the last decade in this particular region, steel start becoming more and more used in the commercial sector. That slide shows the usage of steel buildings in the US in 1986, where you can see that red part, which is commercial usage, is almost about 50% of the usage. That part was totally missed in our areas. We start using steel in our areas in the commercial part only recently in the last 10 years. Yani our colleague when he presented the Mumbai airport as a sample, everybody knows that the old Mumbai airport is fully concrete. There was no steel. So steel started being used in high-rise buildings, in office buildings, in airports, in shopping malls only recently for the last 10 years. So actually we are lacking behind the other side of the world where steel has been used on a wide scale. The recent building applications in our area is the aerospace, defense, aviation, healthcare, mega stores, offices. These are samples of the this usage of steel. Again, in shopping malls, I intentionally put these photos because we want to show people that steel can be architecturally finished in a proper way after having the right finish. Mr. Venkat also he mentioned about the awareness of consultant of the design in steel. One of the major obstacles we face is how to finish the steel buildings, how to look architecturally nice. People are familiar with concrete, plaster, block wall, and other things. But when it comes to steel, still there is not much awareness of how to finish building properly and which architectural component to fit with the steel building. This is multi-level parking, office buildings, university buildings, mega stores, aerospace show. Building steel potentials, of course, as I said, I'm just limiting this to one slide because I think everybody here knows what is the advantages of steel, like the flexibility, the ductility, it's more effective in seismic, time saving in construction, the easy site remedial and modifications. What steel can do? That's a major question. What steel can do? Steel can do everything, more or less. Curved shapes, trusses, high-rise buildings. What steel cannot do? That's another question which we need to answer. What steel cannot do? Actually, I can find that there is nothing steel cannot do. The only item which little bit having a problem with the steel is when you have a high-rise building with a limited clear height, like an office building, for example. So if you're having a construction height of 3 meters, let us say, having a steel will limit the clear heights. But having the, yeah, we cannot compete in that particular requirement with a flat slab solution. If you have a flat slab solution of 200 mm thick, steel cannot compete. No chance. This is the only area where I can see that steel cannot compete. Actually, we are speaking about the advantages of steel, but to be honest, all of us are in the steel business, so we have to think about, again, what is the problems and challenges we are having. We are having this challenge in many buildings here, particularly for a few jobs we ourselves have faced in India, where the height was limited to something around 2.9 finish to finish, and You cannot meet that because you have at least 100 mm slab. You need a construction depth of the beam to at least 300. Then the clear height will be very limited. So in these kind of areas, we are very restricted. What are challenges facing us in steel? The challenges is how to have a cost-effective fireproofing. When we have a presentation about Mumbai Airport, our colleague, he said that the height of the roof make it non-necessary to have fireproofing, which is a valid point. But again, we were forced in that particular project to have encasement of the concrete column and columns in concrete to have proper fireproofing. In many projects we face a problem with the fireproofing where intumescent paint is used, since there is no covering is allowed. So intumescent paint cost is almost equal to the cost of steel, more or less. So that becomes a challenge. When people start comparing the steel, apple to apple to concrete, then fireproofing becomes a major component in the evaluation. So I think this is one of the challenges. We have to find a cost-effective fireproofing to promote steel more and more. Other point is, as I mentioned earlier, the architectural details. How to educate architects and consultants to use steel without fearing that they will not be able to achieve the finish or to use details which they are not aware of. Availability of HR profile. Our friend from MS Steel, he was speaking about this, and I really appreciate what he mentioned about providing or supplying steel for a project in cut to lengths in different sizes. This is one of the areas where we really need to educate the mills in India to do that. But sticking to supplying only in 6 meter, 9 meter, whatever, it's creating a problem because of the waste, because drops is not usable. And I think with the current technology of having CNC machines and controls and other things, it should be possible to give them a list of lenses we need, and they provide cut to lengths. Emirates Steel is doing that, which is highly appreciated, but as he mentioned rightly, the industry in India need to be brought up to that, either in production level, either in availability of sections, or even the end product lenses and other things. The shape of the future steel buildings. Now let us come to the what is the future. I will try to come out of the box slightly and speak about something which may happen within 10 years, whatever, but let us have a look to the future. Now everywhere in the world people are speaking about sustainability and green buildings. Today is in OECD. OECD is the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development. Actually, it includes most of the G7 countries and similar. So it's actually, we're speaking about the other side of the world. Architects and contractors are committed to reshaping our world for the better. People are speaking about how to preserve our planet, where we are living, improving the conditions and other things. So the building industry have to follow that trend. It's still this kind of concept not familiar here much. Maybe in countries like UAE, people start speaking about green buildings. This Masdar project and Masdar city is, again, moving in that direction. But still in other countries in our region, these concepts still has to come. We have to go for energy efficient metal panels, insulation. We have to go for solar reflectivity. People are speaking about which solar reflective index for the cladding. The normal cladding, which has been used for years, now is improving in these countries. They have restrictions on the solar index. They will not approve any cladding material if it doesn't have a minimum solar index reflection to reduce the usage of electricity and heating or air conditioning. The integration with solar energy, this is becoming a major trend in Europe and Canada and US at the moment, where most of the roofs are having these solar panels to produce the electricity or at least part of the electricity needed for the building. People are speaking now about net zero buildings. Net zero buildings means that they are annually produced as much as renewable energy as they consume. So practically, it is self-sustained building. It doesn't require any power supply from outside. If all the buildings are like that, this means that eventually we will end up in the future having no power plants because all entities and buildings are able to produce the energy required by them. and this will reduce also the CO2 emissions and other things. So to move in this direction, we have two lines: energy conservation by means of having solar reflective index insulations and so on, and the other thing, having renewable energy production from the building itself. So this is an example for such buildings where the whole roof is a solar panel producing the electricity needed for the building. So what is the keys to future? How to move in the future as a whole industry and what to do? I believe we have to strengthen the industry technical skills, our own technical skill as steel industry, elevate the industry capabilities either from the mill side or the fabrication side, and advance in the sustainability direction, and utilize and simulate the technology innovation, stimulate. So strengthen technical skills, we have to move into out of the classical structural steel. Yani Mumbai Airport was one of the moves where you go for non-traditional structural system, which require a lot of erection procedures and other things. We have also to move into membrane and cable structures, which saves a lot on the steel itself, steel consumptions in the building, and give a lot of architectural features. These are sample of these membrane and cable structures. We have to strengthen our capabilities internally by moving into the building information model concept, the BIM, where all the disciplines in the building are integrated in one computer model, where the electromechanical, the structural, the services, everything is integrated in one model. Actually, BIM has moved into many directions. Rather than doing models in 3D, they have gone into 4D, which they call it integrating with the production facility. So you are tracking the product within the factory, introducing cost, which they call it 5D, and also allowing to extract any information, what they call it 6D. So all this integration will help in reducing the amount of construction time and the changes on site, because once all the electromechanical services, everything is integrated in one model, then the chances of having revisions and changes on the site will be far less, because everything is studied properly. To elevate industrial capabilities, we come to the same point of having HR range of sections. The range of sections available currently, not in Emirates Steel, of course, but at least in India, is far less. And ISMB sections are not really efficient. It's very heavy sections. So the steel mills in India have to move out of that capacity-wise and section-wise to support the industry. Rolling cut to length is one of the major features required for our business, because this will eliminate a lot of splicing in the shop, will eliminate drops, and will make the steel more cheap and effective. Again, we have to go for higher quality built-ups. So built-up is one of the good solutions, but we have to have the facility of doing automatic welding and having proper lines to do this more effectively. Automation also is one of the points which will improve the quality and the speed of production for the steel fabrication units. To advance in sustainability, we have to go for energy conservation, as we mentioned earlier, by doing high-performance wall and roof constructions. Renewable energy production by utilizing solar panels, going for net zero buildings concept. Now there is a software doing this integrated with the BIM. These softwares are available already in US and Canada, where you put all your buildings, extract the information from the BIM about the services, about the ducts, about everything, about the insulation, then calculates the power requirement for the building. Now we have to go for the part of the technology innovations. So technology innovations, nowadays people are speaking about photovoltaic paint. So practically, rather than putting a photo cells, there is a paint producing electricity. This is the latest innovation in that field. We have also 3D printing. I don't know if you are aware of 3D printing or not, but 3D printing historically have been developed over the last, let us say, 10 to 15 years, where practically you are putting, instead of putting paper in the printing in the printer, you are putting a plastic cube, okay, let us say a plastic cube or a plastic solid. And rather than having a head spraying paint on the paper or spraying ink, you are really having a head engraving in that plastic piece to generate a 3D model of whatever you want. That was used mainly to create a mock-up for different industries rather than creating the real part. So you create, let us, automotive industry. You create a simulative plastic part, then you can do whatever verifications and other things. Now this business has been improved a little bit, and we have gone to 3D printing on steel. So practically for having a connection like this, rather than having that part with a lot of welding and very complex, you can have that part simulated by 3D model and printed using that kind of printer, engraving in steel and creating that. People are believing that this will have a lot of, let us say, a lot of usage in the future, because you can create more complex and solve a lot of complex problems which is very difficult to fabricate normally by cutting and welding, and there is no access to weld and so on. This technology also is used currently for something totally beyond steel in any case, but it's for medical purpose, is using this 3D printing for creating this artificial tooth. So practically they take a shot of your mouse and tooth arrangements and pass this to a small printer, but rather than putting a plastic solid inside, they put a porcelain piece inside and they engrave that porcelain piece to come up with the required tooth. So that 3D printing, they call it printing, actually it's not a printing, it's engraving, let us say. That business is improving and it's feeding a lot of industries at the moment. Yeah. So we feel that this will be the future of steel buildings, and utilizing these kind of technologies, innovations, green buildings and so on, this will be our future, and it will enhance the usage of steel in the industry. This is all what I say. I can say, so thank you very much. And, thank you.